Eventually, they go to the refrigerator and they see the note. They open it up and they see the FBI donuts. Unfortunately, they didn't eat one of them. The FBI wasn't hunting me at the time. I wasn't a fugitive, but I knew they were after me because they had sent this informant, who was actually a criminal hacker, to befriend me because this guy got himself into trouble for credit card fraud and he became a cooperator slash informant. They said the quote was, "You'd have a real feather in your cap if you could help us nail Mitnick." What I worked out is I was able to get this informant's telephone number. Back in the day, this was before caller ID even existed in California because it wasn't tariffed yet. So I was able through the phone company to add the caller ID feature to a friend's phone. And then this informant, the only way I could reach him, he'd never give me his home phone, he'd only give me his pager number. So what I did is at 3 a.m, I paged him to call the number where I added the caller ID feature and is able to find his home phone number. Because who's, you're gonna be at home at 3 a.m. Now I had his home phone number. And then I was able to look at his phone bill because I was able to, you know, hack into Pacific Bell back in the day. What I saw was some interesting numbers that this guy was calling. They eventually worked out to be direct numbers at the FBI offices in Los Angeles to agents. So they had a number that would answer with somebody's voicemail that would say they're on the White Collar Crime Squad 3. So I easily worked out that matching the cell phone numbers that belonged to these agents based on the guy's pattern of phone calls. And so I had a device, and I was working as a private investigator in LA at the time, that I interfaced with my computer and a scanner. So anytime these phone numbers that I classified as FBI cell phones came into my location, into my area, I'd get a warning on my computer, it would beep. One morning I go into the office and I hear this beeping like it's like, "You didn't disable an alarm?" Unbelievably, the beeping is coming from my office. And I go, "What's that?" And I walk up to the computer and it's my early warning system detected one of the FBI cell phones. And I'm going, "Oh my God, they're here." What I see from the data it captured is that phone called a payphone number that was across the street from my apartment at 6:30 a.m. So they were there, but it was like 2 hours earlier. That's interesting. Why would the FBI be at my apartment, but they wouldn't arrest me? Then it hit me, they were there to get a search warrant. So, with this foreknowledge that the FBI was at my residence, I decided to take anything related to computers, all my floppy disks, everything out of the apartment and put it at a friend's house. And then I went to the local Winchell's Donut House and bought a dozen donuts. And on the box I wrote, "FBI donuts." I stuck in the refrigerator. And then on the outside of the refrigerator, I don't know if you're familiar with the Intel Inside logo. It says Intel Inside. I wrote FBI donuts inside and I stuck it to the refrigerator. And once you know it, at 6 a.m, my doorknob is wiggling. I jump out of bed because I know that the FBI doesn't do that. They knock on the door. And I actually go to the door and I open it and there's like a team of FBI agents. And they go, "You're Kevin Mitnick. We have a search warrant." And they all poured in. They're all looking for all the computers, the floppy disks, and all this stuff. They find nothing. They even call a supervisor because there was nothing there. And then, of course, eventually they go to the refrigerator and they see the note. They open it up and they see the FBI donuts. Unfortunately, they didn't eat one of them, but that tipped them off that I knew they were coming, so they were pretty pissed.